Hi, I'm Lachlan, and today I'm going to walk you through what is Meraki and how does it work. Full disclosure, I do work for Cisco Meraki. However, this video is not sponsored. If you do have any questions or want to connect, there's my email, also my LinkedIn. All the links in this presentation are live, so feel free to click through those in your own time. I'll put this presentation down in the video description. So what is Meraki? Meraki is secure, simple cloud managed networking. But what do we mean by that? By secure, we mean we leverage industry-leading security features off the back of being part of Cisco in terms of protecting not only the traffic being transmitted across our network and encrypting that, but also preventing attacks on our networks as well. Meraki is also simple by design, and this means we do away with a lot of the nuanced features of traditional networking, and we've really distilled them down to the core, most important features you need. And this helps simplify not only the management and monitoring, because there's now not an incredible feature list you have to learn all the nuances of everything with. You simply have a handful of really well-documented, really well-covered features that are the most critical, most common, and most important to running your network. Finally, we're cloud managed. That's that idea that we decouple the control plane from the actual logic plane, and it means that we can remotely configure, remotely monitor, remotely troubleshoot a network, and have the output of a massive team of IT personnel with a very lean IT team. And this gives us a lot of flexibility and a lot of power to get insights into the network. Now, to understand Meraki, it's good to understand how networks have evolved over time. And the way this has happened for businesses traditionally, we'd have the internet, we'd have a head office, and we'd have a number of branch locations. And in between each of those, we have a very expensive but high performance MPLS connection. Over time though, as businesses have moved more and more to SaaS applications, that's software as a service, and this as a service model, we've seen less than ideal SaaS application performance because we now get this bottlenecking effect at the head office. We get a really expensive and hard to maintain and scale system because every time we want to put a branch office online, we need another expensive MPLS connection and likely a multi-year agreement. On top of that as well, it's very, very hard for us to add things like remote workers. It's very hard now to manage and monitor this network. And businesses ultimately don't want to lock themselves in with these large capital projects. They want to have far more flexibility and far more risk mitigation via more of an operational expenditure model or an as a service model. And this is what Meraki helps support. So how does Meraki do that? And the way it does that is by logically, not physically, moving the head office out of the way and also supporting remote workers. And so once we've done that, we now connect all our workers, our branch offices, and our head office via the internet and two broadband connections at each of those sites. This supports software-defined wide area networking. And what that means is because we can now load balance our traffic over these two connections, we will approach MPLS type performance without the need for expensive high performance MPLS links, leading to great cost savings, a far more cost effective way to scale, manage, and monitor your networks, and also ideal SaaS application performance. Because we can now connect to the internet directly, we can get to those applications in a far more seamless and user first way. Now, for all these advantages of SD-WAN, it's really important that you understand you need an easy way to manage and monitor SD-WAN networks, and you also need a really easy way to administer robust security. That's where Meraki comes in. Now, why Meraki? Why do businesses choose to go with Meraki? And there's a whole host of reasons, but primarily they're business-based pain points that Meraki solves for. So starting with network security. I'll touch on this at the end as well. If you want firewall that's industry leading, you want unified threat management, you want sandboxing, you want intrusion prevention, all that is built into Meraki off the back of leveraging Cisco's industry leading security solutions. If you want to simplify the management and monitoring of your network, giving yourself that one true single pane of glass, there's no second login, there's no second dashboard, there only is one dashboard, and that's where all Meraki devices on your network will be managed and monitored from. If you want flexible scalability, and flexible functionality, adding things like smart cameras, adding things like Internet of Things devices over time so you can do things like advanced monitoring of your physical locations, Meraki is a great fit. If you've got lean IT teams, you want to increase their effectiveness without increasing the headcount of your IT team, Meraki is a great fit. If you want to be able to troubleshoot in a fast and effective way and really identify exactly where things are going wrong, Meraki can easily support that with our built-in features and troubleshooting capacity. And if you want to save time, ultimately, by not running your network, but adding value through projects and other activities, Meraki, again, is a good fit. And the reason we say that, simply ask yourself, how does my business make money? If your business doesn't make money by running your network, you shouldn't be spending time just running your network and getting it up to a level where it performs. Meraki performs by default because we have quality, high performance, long lasting solutions, ultimately reducing the total cost of ownership. Because we are such high quality devices, we offer such a robust, easy, and scalable way to build your network. We do require an initial investment, but over time, as you don't need to replace devices frequently, as you can add extra devices as you require them, or even repurpose them very flexibly, Meraki is a really good fit. And that's why ultimately businesses pick Meraki, because they want those business pain points solved for. If you want the cheapest product, we're not going to be that. If you want one that's robust, that's going to add value, give you ability to build other applications on and do far more things, Meraki's a good fit. Now, there are 9 core Meraki devices, but instead of just listing these, let's actually go ahead and build an example Meraki network. Again, all the links in this presentation are live. Find the link to this presentation in the video description. So let's create an example Meraki network. SaaS applications on the internet on the left there, a Windows end user on the right. First device we're going to add, Meraki's MX appliances. Routers, unified threat management, next-gen firewall, software-defined wide area networking, auto VPN, 4G failover. All that functionality built into one device. Next, we're going to add Meraki switches, our MS series here, multi-gigabit Ethernet and fiber and virtual stacking. And now we've got our Windows end user online. Now you would have also seen the Meraki dashboard come up here. That's that one single pane of glass to manage and monitor all Meraki devices. Our MX appliances, our MS appliances here, all being managed by that same dashboard. Now Meraki's MG series, 4G wireless gateways. This will give us a reliable broadband quality internet connection via nothing more than a 4G LTE signal. And now we've got those two connections, the wired and the wireless connection into our MX SD-WAN capable appliance, which we can now load balance over and approach that MPLS type performance without that MPLS link. Next, we're going to add some software, Meraki Insight. This is software that runs off the back of our MX appliances and gives us insights into our SaaS application performance. Are the users getting a good experience? What's the jitter and latency like for our connections? Let's take the power back from the ISP and actually hold them accountable for the actual SLAs they're telling us they're providing by actually being able to monitor that and even provide that back to them if they aren't meeting those SLAs. Next up, Meraki's access points. Indoor and outdoor access points. Outdoor ones ruggedized for external use, indoor for indoor use. External antennas supported if you want to segment certain areas or certain high density deployments, or even save on the number of APs you need to buy. And Wi-Fi 6 support as well for high density and IoT deployments. Next up, we've got Meraki Systems Manager. This is mobile device management software that can be installed on all common operating systems, including those listed here and more. And what this allows you to do is get really granular information and feedback in terms of physically where devices are located. You can actually wipe the devices if they are being lost or stolen. You can actually make sure that devices have the right firmware updates. You can enforce certain policies and get far more control than would otherwise be possible on end user devices. Next up, we'll add Meraki's MV series smart cameras, outdoor and indoor smart cameras. And the reason we call them smart cameras is because they're more than just security cameras. They're visual sensors on the network, fully digital, and using our OpenREST APIs, developers can develop third-party applications for these cameras, doing things like social distancing, number plate recognition, analyzing foot traffic in retail stores. All that can be done with Meraki smart cameras. Now built in as well, there's also functionality like motion search. Don't sit through hours of footage to find an event, search an area for when an event occurred, get a list succinctly of all the events that have occurred, export that footage, send it in for an insurance claim. Classic use case for Meraki smart cameras. Finally, Meraki's newest product line, the MT series of Internet of Things sensors. And what these can sense are things like temperature, humidity, open and close, and also water leaks, and feed all that information back to the Meraki dashboard for monitoring and configuration via any MV smart camera or any MR wireless access point that has Wi-Fi 6 connectivity. What you've got here is an entire network built out on Meraki. Obviously very simplified for illustrative purposes, but gives you an idea of the power and flexibility Meraki can help provide. The beauty of Meraki is you don't need to have everything with Meraki. You will get the most from a network if everything was with Meraki, because everything will talk to each other seamlessly and you get far more options in terms of configuration and monitoring. However, if you only want to add access points, absolutely fine with Meraki. If you only want to add, say, our MX appliances, absolutely fine with Meraki. A lot of flexibility there. And if you grow over time, you can add and remove or repurpose devices with Meraki as well. Now, I touched on this at the start. Meraki Security is an absolute core part of Meraki's offering. The fact we're owned by Cisco, we leverage Cisco smarts in terms of network security and the security architectures therein. Cisco Talos, threat intelligence, one of the world's largest privately owned security companies, engineers actively identifying threats globally, and our network intelligence being fed back to central databases, which are then updated. Threats are identified, either marked as being a threat or not, and that information is then pushed back out to Meraki devices globally. That ability to have enterprise-grade security provided seamlessly at an end-user site where there's potentially not even one person working full-time in an IT role, absolutely indispensable. On top of that, DNS spoofing protection with Cisco Umbrella, available with our advanced wireless licensing on Meraki access points. Cisco AMP or advanced malware protection, that can be accessed with Cisco Meraki MX appliances. And on top of that as well, threat grid integrations as well, to have a sandbox environment in which you can open programs, assess whether they're malicious or not, and actually blow them away if they are. Top of that, intrusion prevention, powered by Snort as the engine doing that, intrusion prevention and detection. On top of that as well, analytics and insights with StealthWatch through Cisco, posture and policy with Cisco IC and TrustSec, and finally, remote access VPN through Cisco AnyConnect. Now, core to understanding Meraki's products is also understanding Meraki licensing. All Meraki hardware has a matching license on a 1, 3, 5, 7, or 10-year term. And what that licensing provides is Meraki dashboard access for product configuration and monitoring, firmware and feature updates. If any new features are pushed to your devices via a firmware update, you receive them free of charge. Vulnerability patches and updates are pushed quickly and automatically. For example, the WannaCry attack about a year ago now, that was analyzed and assessed and blocked by Meraki automatically. 24/7 phone and email support, offices in Sydney, San Francisco, and London. So there's always someone to speak to and help augment your IT team in terms of technical capacity. And finally, lifetime warranty whilst licensed. If you had an access point, for example, 9.5 years into a 10-year license period, the access point was assessed by tech support to have actually failed through no fault of your own, that device would be replaced free of charge. So you're effectively insured whilst with Meraki. Now, to simplify things, license expiry here by default is co-termination licensing. That means there's one date on which all licensing is due for renewal. If you need more granularity or more control, say for certain sites or certain organizations within your organization, per device licensing is an option too. Finally there, the Meraki dashboard service level agreement. That's 99.9% uptime on the dashboard alone, not the devices themselves. And what that translates to is less than 1 hour downtime per year we expect on our dashboard. And on top of that as well, the devices themselves will not stop passing packets or switching. They just simply will not be able to be configured or monitored during that time. Now, on top of the license term, for some products, there is also a license type. So for example, our MX security appliances, you would pick between Enterprise, Advanced Security, or SD-WAN Plus licenses. Most people, for example, pick Advanced Security. For our access points, you would pick between Enterprise and Advanced Wireless if you wanted to add Cisco Umbrella. And with our MV Smart Cameras, you would pick between Enterprise and Cloud Archive if you wanted to add up to a year of cloud archival footage. And that's it. It's that easy to license with Meraki. Pick a term, pick a license type if relevant, and that's it. You're up and running. No additional licenses for additional features. Everything is provided by default and upfront. And that's pretty much it. That's a quick high-level overview of Meraki. That's how the different devices interoperate, and it's also how the licensing works and why people typically will choose to go with Meraki. Any questions, send me an email or contact me on LinkedIn. Thanks.